Hey everyone, I'm Josh from Green Mountain Grills, and today I'm going to show you the different functionalities on a control panel for the Green Mountain Grill Prime. First, I want to show how to do a hot start. Now this is something that you'll want to do if for some reason your grill gets shut off mid-cook. There's a quick way to get it running right to where it was. First, you're going to tap the power button once, and then you're just going to press and hold the button again until you get a temperature readout. Once you see that temp readout, you can let go and you'll hear the fan kick on and the grill will start running. If you had a temperature up higher, you'll want to set it up manually to where you had it, and it'll pick up right where you left off. If you want to turn off your grill without unplugging it, just press and hold the power button until the display goes blank. To get the power to come back on, just press and hold the power button until the display lights up. The next thing I want to show you is how to change from Fahrenheit to Celsius. And when the display says off, you just press and hold the down button until you see it change. It'll either go to F or C. So see, it's on C. Now to switch it back, you just press and hold it again, and you're back on Fahrenheit. All right, here we got our probes. When using a prime, the meat probe should have a 200 etched on the base of it. If you're using a different meat probe for a different grill and doesn't have that 200 etched on it, it will not work on a prime. Now to read probe one, this is the probe one port. You just tap that button, you'll see FD1, and it'll show you your food temperature right there. Now, if you want to set a food temperature alarm, you can increase the readout to your desired internal temp and the grill will alert you when that temperature is reached. To switch between probes, you can press either probe button. If you're on probe one, you can switch to probe two, and you'll see it says FD2 for food two port, and you'll see here it says NFD, and that means that there's no meat probe plugged in. So then you just go back to your food one, see it there, and then you can just switch it back to the grill temperature by pressing probe one again. Next, I'm going to show you how to quickly do a Wi-Fi reset. To do this, unplug the grill from the back, press and hold probe one, and then plug the grill back in while still holding that probe one button. After about 8 to 10 seconds, you should start to see the count up start on the display. You can let go when you see that. It'll go from 0 to 999 and then back to off when it's finished. Once it's back to off, you should see your Wi-Fi signal rebroadcasting in your Wi-Fi settings in your phone. Next, I'll show you how to do a firmware check. To do this, you're gonna wanna unplug the grill from the back of the hopper, press and hold the up arrow, and then plug the grill back in. After a few seconds, you should see the firmware version display, and then after that, it'll read off the serial number for this board, which is also the password for the Wi-Fi. On a Prime Plus, you'll notice that there's a switch below your control panel here. This is for the light inside your grill. So those are the different functionalities on the control panel for a Green Mountain Grill Prime. For more tips and tricks, head to greenmountaingrills.com for more.